Kobe blitzing. They pick it up. He throws end zone. Caught. Touchdown, Jeremy Gallen. He leaps up to make an acrobatic TD grab. It's Jeremy Gallen breaking a tackle. He's loose at the 15 through a spin move to the 10, to the 5. Touchdown, Michigan.
ESPN Live continues. Just hours to go until the NFL draft. Howard and Mike back here. As promised, we bring in a guest who could hear his name called this weekend. He is Jeremy Gallen, the former Michigan wideout star. All right, Jeremy, preparing for this upcoming NFL draft, what's this whole process been like for you?
It's been kind of crazy, just hanging around with the family, just basically waiting there. And you try to stay away from the TV, really, and just not listen to or look at the SportsCenter or anything like that, just trying to enjoy my time before heading into wherever I head to.
Jeremy, what have you been hearing from your agent as far as teams that will be possibly interested in making you a part of their team?
It's funny because I've been telling them just not to tell me anything, man. Just let me wait on the phone call and just let me just have this time with my family. But he's been trying to, just let me know what teams have been calling, like the Patriots and San Diego and the Raiders and, there's a bunch of other teams. But I've just been really just trying to stay away from it, just enjoy my time, my family.
When you talk to those teams, how much have you been actively selling yourself by saying, I could be a Wes Welker for you, I could be a Steve Smith type?
Almost every conversation that I have with any coach on the phone, I'm not the biggest guy, so I have to sell myself a little bit more than other guys, So just almost every conversation that I have with any coach that I get a chance to talk to, so.
You know, those coaches are you're selling yourself, and those coaches have questions for you about what you think you can do better. What are some of the, I won't call them negative criticisms, or some of the things that they thought maybe you needed to work on when you make the step to the next level?
Well, obviously, it's my height, but I don't think I can work on that.
Yeah, you don't have to worry about that part.
But, nah, man, just working against, bigger and stronger guys, they're more physical. As a smaller guy, you got to be. You got to be more physical, you got to be stronger, you got to be, quicker off the ball than a lot smarter than others, just to be two steps or a step ahead of everyone else. So it's basically everything that they've been telling me I've been trying to work on from the past year. So
what are you going to miss most about playing for the Wolverines?
My team, team 132 all the way to team 134. I mean, it's been a great opportunity for me to play for that. The university, and just to run down that tunnel with my teammates and just to lock hands and just pray after games and sing the fight song in the student section, man, and just look at the crowd and see how crazy they are and see how fun it is on Saturdays and see the fans after the game. And everything about the program I'm gonna miss, and the coaches I'm gonna miss, because there's never a time that you can call them and talk to them about anything. They're always there for you, and they always, have your best interest and always there to support you. So everything about that, I'm going to miss and I'm going to love. So.
When you think back on your time with Michigan, give me your favorite memory of Brady Hoke.
My favorite memory? I don't know, man. It's a lot of them. He has a lot of them. But the one that I can remember, it's the Notre Dame game, night game. To me, I just felt like he was extra pumped up for that game. He came and gave us a great speech in the locker room, and it had us pumped up and ready to go. And to me, I just, it was nothing better than just hearing him come out and just, pouring everything and letting us know how he feels, because to me, I think he's a quiet guy in the locker room, just let everybody sit back and get in their own zone. But he came out and he got us ready, and I was really feeling that, and I really appreciated that. And we went out and we did a hell of a job. So.
There was no secrets that you and Devin Gardner are quite close. What do you see his future being like? He has to play under now a new offensive coordinator. How do you see him being able to make that transition?
I've been around, and he's making the transition that pretty well. I mean, he's a smart guy. He's able to adapt to anything, I think, that's given or thrown at him. And he's been doing a good job so far. I mean, from the practices and spring game, I think he's that guy. He's ready for the next level. I mean, there's always room for improvement, but to me, I think he's been handling the transition very well.
You know, these two are really close, Howard. In fact, I remember last year, Jeremy once told me he and Devin were closer than Phineas and Ferb.
Yep.
And then there was a special moment that happened on BTN. And I'd like to play that clip. So listen closely here, Jeremy, about this great moment from this past year.
All right.
L is for the way you look at me.
O is for the only one I see.
V is very, very extraordinary.
E, I don't know the rest of the song.
Is even more than anyone that you'd... All right, we leave it.
Well done, fellas. Well done. Devin Gardner, Jeremy Gallen. Thanks, boys.
We should have did that. Hey, no problem. Go Blue.
Do you remember that, Jeremy?
Good time.
You guys had some game, man. What's it going to be like to not play with him this year?
It'll be a little different, but it's something that I have to live with. I mean, I don't have a choice to, you know, I mean, but it's something that I have to live with. And, I mean, I think I'm ready for it, but it's not like we're going to stop communicating with one another. We're always going to be brothers and best friends, but, you know, it's something that I have to live with, something that we can get used to.
Who's going to replace you? Who's the guy that can be his go-to wide receiver on next year's team?
I don't know, man. It's a bunch of guys out there. I mean, you got a bunch of upcoming freshmen. You got some guys like Punchy. You got Darbo, J.U. Chesson, Dennis Northley. You got guys that's standing out and doing a great job leading the receiving corps and just trying to be the best player they can for the team. So, I mean, you got a bunch of guys that stand out to me that can be that guy.
Jeremy, as a leader on the team, when you finally leave, I think you always are asked to part some wisdom on some of the younger guys that are going to be coming up. What words of wisdom do you have for the younger guys that are still at Michigan?
Just work until it's your time, man. Never give up there. Always, always work for the man next to you. I mean, there's no I in team, man. So, I mean, just go and do everything you can for your teammates and just fight for the man next to you. And just give it all like it's your last, man, because you never know. I mean, it could be your last season, could be your last day, could be your last game playing football ever. But until that day comes, man, just fight like it's your last. So.
Jeremy Gallen, it's been great to watch you catch balls for Michigan. It's been great to hear you sing as a member of the Wolverines, too. Best of luck this weekend, man.
Still need some work on that. Appreciate it.